listening to Sound Opinions. I'm Jim Deergottis here with my partner Greg Kahn, and this week we are presenting another installment of our summer school series. This time we're tackling a question that may be obvious to some. Why do the Ramones matter? You know, that's right, Jim. The Ramones formed in Queens, New York in 74, and the original lineup was lead singer Joey Ramone, guitarist Johnny Ramone, bass guitarist D.D. Ramone, and drummer Tommy Ramone. Now, they weren't brothers, but they took... That's bubblegum pop. They modeled themselves after these kind of melodic, chart-topping bubblegum bands of the 60s in some ways. And although they were never at the top of the... their influence on both punk music and on American culture at the or singles or hear it on the radio. But these people, you know, generations subsequent to the Ramones' arrival haven't really been able to dig into why the band has mattered beyond their iconic status. Well, when we heard the title of this new book, Why the Ramones Matter, one of our producers, Ayana, said, yeah, I'd like to know. And so we said, there's a show. That book, Why the Ramones Matter, is the latest from Donna Gaines, sociologist, a journalist, a fine critic, and now an author. To discuss the musical, social, and even political contributions of the band, we turn to Donna.
Well, that's exactly what I have. Back to the people, and if you listen to any of their albums, they literally are instructional manuals to teach you how to play music, so you can show up not have money to buy expensive clothes, not have any big connections, not to have a perfect body or even a perfect mind, and you can do rock and roll, and that's all good. But I think to that 18-year-old kid, and I think that little kid is still alive in me. That liveliness and curiosity and just excitement about life, they gave kids the power to create their own cultural products. They disseminated the idea of do it yourself, so that like you could set up a band, you could set up shows, you could print out flyers, you could book shows, you could get guest lists together. They really taught young people how to do it for themselves, and you know that that's very radical. But the most exquisite thing is the ethic of inclusion with songs like Outsider and Pinhead, where they say, gobble, gobble, we accept you, one of us. So they created space for the outcast. They made it, if you were not really hitting it at school or at home or on the street, if you were the kind of kid who hung out like the Ramones did, like I did, on street corners, what BB called the obvious creeps of the neighborhood. You know, you're a creative person that is of value. You know, you're not just a punk on the street that the police, think is a nuisance and everybody kind of labels as a loser. The value that the Ramones have not only expressed musically, but lived. And who they were, which is pretty famous in music, it keeps everybody shocked. And especially now with the tricks and the bullying and all the creepy texting, the short-term BS that, education, which is all the craziness, it gives people some fresh air.
Fucking crazy.
You like that shit?
That was Donna Gaines, author of Why the Ramones Matter. Tommy Ramone, born from us, third alive, wore a lot of different hats as founder of the group, his drummer, his producer. When we spoke to Tommy back in 2007, he was the last surviving original member of the Ramones, and he died in 2015. Among other subjects, we talked to Tommy about how the band came together and about the distinctive backing that Tommy contributed to the sound of the Ramones.
I met John in high school, after first year of high school, and we bonded right away. He was a really witty, funny guy, and he moved into the neighborhood in the year of and Joey, I knew, actually I met Joey from John, so we had jam session. And he was like,
Let's get
which really strange.
It always been. So the satirical take on suburban life and staying with the family and drugs street culture. Yeah. This was all in terms of the subject matter. It was there from the start.
Yeah. They came in with lots of baggage.
I'm a drummer myself. And I think Ramones never get enough credit for their music.